Hi, I'm Jonathan Edwards, and this is Be Still and Know. Let's listen to the Bible together and hear what God is saying to us today. Jeremiah chapter 7, verses 5 and 6. I will be merciful only if you stop your evil thoughts and deeds and start treating each other with justice. Only if you stop exploiting foreigners, orphans and widows. Only if you stop your murdering. And only if you stop harming others by worshipping idols. Most of the time, we probably think of justice as being something which is in the hands of other people. We look to the police and the law courts to handle issues of justice, and we wish them well as they do so. But these verses make it clear that justice is something which involves us all. We all need to think and to act justly. And that's a challenge every day of our lives. Continually, we have to make judgments about what is just, whether it's in our family, business, school, college, church, or sports club. And God was clear that he would only be merciful to his people if they were willing to take their responsibility for justice seriously. The fact is, we live in a deeply unfair world, and although massive strides have been made in recent centuries, it's still the case that there are people who suffer because of their age, gender, ethnicity, appearance, ability, disability, education or income. The whole Bible encourages us to be on our toes. We should be looking out for those who are vulnerable in our society, and wherever we live, we won't need to look far to find them. It isn't good enough to merely wish them well. We need to stand with them and explore ways in which they can be supported. The Old Testament was particularly sensitive to the vulnerability of foreigners. Having lived in another country for a few years, I easily understand the vulnerability of those who move from one country to another. But my situation was not that of a refugee. I can't imagine how awful it would be to be forcibly displaced. But the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees believes that there are more than 80 million people in the world in that position. And the number has doubled in the past 10 years. We can't change the world by ourselves, but we can pray, and we can reach out to those in our own communities who need our prayers, our love, and our practical support. Let me pray with you. Loving God, forgive us for the times when we have left issues of justice to others and haven't been eager to fight for it and protect vulnerable people. Amen. Thanks for listening. I encourage you to join me every day for Be Still and Know. You can also hear me on podcast at any time. And if you'd like to receive a free copy of our magazine, Voice of Hope, which contains all of these devotionals and much else besides, please visit premier.org.uk/Voice of Hope. God bless you. I do hope you have a great day.